So, good morning, students. Today we are going to continue the chapter Life Processes, class 10th. So, today's topic is Nutrition in Human Beings. So, there's one very nice saying that goes about, whatever you eat, you shall become. If you eat a healthy diet, you will be fit, fine and healthy. If you eat a lesser healthy diet, that will reflect in your day-to-day life, in your day-to-day practices. So, let's begin. So, healthy and proper diet is indispensable for a healthy body. You can't think of a healthy body and a healthy mind without proper healthy diet. So, why do we need to eat? The reasons are energy for various life processes. Even when we are sleeping, we need some energy for our basic life functions to go on. Whether it is your brain, whether it is all your organs, they need energy. Each and every cell of your body, they need energy. And that energy we obtain from the food we eat. So, for repairing damage and for wear and tear. Repairing damage means many a times in our tissues we have an injury. So, to repair them, we must get energy. And for proper wear and tear. The cells keep on dying, so we have to produce new cells, we have to build on new tissues, for building muscles and tissues, for breathing, walking, sleeping, thinking, for your reproductive organs, for each and every organ and each and every system, whether it is excretory, respiratory, reproductive, they all need energy, and for that we need food. So let us start this journey of how the digestion of food happens in your body. So, alimentary canal is a long tube extending from mouth to anus where digestion takes place, and it consists of the following organs. So, alimentary canal, it starts from the mouth and ends at anus, and it consists of all these organs. Buccal cavity, which is this, then buccal cavity contains your mouth and the pharynx, then stomach, which is the J-shaped organ, large intestine, liver, food pipes, small intestine, anus and pancreas. Out of this, the organs that are part of alimentary canal are only buccal cavity, stomach, large intestine, anus, small intestine and food pipe. The liver and the pancreas are not the main organs of the digestive system. They are the accessory organs. Okay, children, so there are two types of organs of your digestive system, main organs and the accessory organs. Liver and pancreas come under the category of accessory organs. So, main parts of the digestive system, the pathway of digestion. Whenever we eat food, it goes from your mouth to pharynx to esophagus to stomach, then it goes to small intestine, then it goes to large intestine, and finally undesirable or undigested food is removed from the anus. So, this is the pathway. Mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. This area, this part of large intestine is called rectum. So, digestion in mouth. Now, let's begin to our first part, the most important part which actually starts up this process of digestion, which is mouth. Yes, the process of digestion starts in the mouth itself, and the first culminators are teeth. What do the teeth do? They are used for crushing and cutting the food into small pieces. And other than cutting and crushing the teeth into food into small pieces, tongue also helps in swallowing the food. It helps us to swallow, and tongue and teeth with saliva together convert the food into bolus. B-O-L-U-S. This bolus are circular formed things which actually make the food more easily digestible. So saliva also contains a salivary amylase. Salivary amylase is an enzyme which converts starch into sugar. So salivary gland releases saliva which digests the carbohydrate, partially starch. So if you want to see whether the salivary amylase work or not, you can do it right now also. Just take a bite of chapati. And when you will eat it, the chapati contains carbohydrate. At first, it will not taste sweet. But slowly and steadily, if you keep on chewing that chapati piece again and again, after some time, it will start tasting sweeter to you. The reason is starch in the chapati has been converted into sugar. And this process is called mastication. when your tongue, mouth and saliva, all three act together, crush the food and mix it with saliva for bolus, this process is called mastication. And this is your fun fact.